Good evening and welcome to MTV News Update for today, Thursday, April 5, 2018. In the news tonight, military presence at Guyana-Venezuela border heightens following continuous reports of armed gangs in the area. APNU-AFC to contest local government election as one party. Prime Minister Moses Nagamutu returns home following a heart surgery. And the parking meter one step closer to return. With the details of these and other stories, I'm Sandy Ramutar, thanking you for joining us. We start tonight's newscast by telling you that, with reports of armed gangs at the Guyana-Venezuela border, a high-level security delegation led by Minister of Public Security Kamran Ramjeten has been dispatched to address the matter. Here's more in this report. Minister of Public Security Kamran Ramjeten, led by the Parliamentary Oversight Committee on the Security Sector, visited Region 1. The visit follows reports of armed gangs in the Cuyuni River, which is said to be affecting the work of Guyanese miners. So says Minister of State Joseph Harmon.
That the Guyana Defense Force and the Guyana Police Force had mounted high-level, high-ranking visits to the area in an approach which includes citizens, the Guyana Gold and Diamond Miners Association, the Ministry of Natural Resources, Corps of Wardens. And this is an attempt to collectively address the security situation which has been widely reported in some of our newspapers.
In addition to this, a high-level delegation from the Guyana Defense Force and the Guyana Police Force has been dispatched to the borderline. The borderline communities, according to Minister Harmon, will be graced by frequent military presence. Residents there were also assured that the matter is being addressed by the government and their safety would not be compromised.
But certainly patrolling is a routine activity for the forces. What, however, happens is that from time to time, there are things which occur on the border, and because, as I said again, of the instantaneousness of communication, somebody out there with a cell phone calls somebody in Georgetown, sends a text. And therefore, even before the security forces can respond to it, it is here in the newspaper, it is here by persons in Georgetown complaining, well, what are you doing about it? And so it requires, of course, time to get to the security forces where they are based for them to respond and to go to deal with these matters.
President David Granger has also promised to engage the village councils and tushars to address the challenges faced by residents there. Chairman of the Alliance for Change, Kamran Ramjeten, has assured that the relationship between his party and the Partnership for National Unity is quite cordial, regardless of the issues at City Hall. Details on this, Nikhil Jondo report.
Chairman of the Alliance for Change, Kamran Ramjeten, during an interview says the recent behavior of Town Clerk Royston King has left much to be discussed among the party. Ramjeten noted that despite the Town Clerk's behavior, the two parties' relationship is cordial at the highest level. The issue at City Hall has caused AFC's Sherrod Duncan to file a no-confidence motion against King. That motion, which was eventually struck out, was seconded by the other AFC member at City Hall, Lionel Jaikaran. However, the AFC chairman posited that the rumblings in the Georgetown municipality are not reflective of the relationship between the AFC and the APNU.
We have seen an unfortunate development in the municipality, and we indicated that, you know, the attitude of especially the town clerk has left a lot of things bothering us. And so we have to make our statements. We have done that, and we intend to also indicate to the APNU officials what it is that we are concerned about.
The AFC chairman believes that the recent outcome of the parking meter bylaws and the renegotiation of the contract were not as a result of the AFC losing the post of deputy mayor.
We have to learn to live with democratic decisions. And indeed, I rather suspect that those who voted the way they didn't like the principled positions of Sherrod and Dr. Jaikaran. And so, if they have the majority in that council and they want the new guy, Peters, well, they will have him. We can't now go and say, well, that was undemocratic. And so that is how this country must go. If they feel that Dr. Jaikaran will not get their support for one reason, whether it's emotional, irrational, whatever the reason, that's it.
Former Deputy Mayor Lionel Jaikaran was not renominated for a second term. His predecessor, Sherrod Duncan, another AFC member, did not seek re-election after his term ended in 2016. Nikhil Jondo reporting for MTV News Update.
Prime Minister Moses Nakamoto has returned to Guyana this morning, where an official ceremony was hosted to welcome him home. The PM underwent a successful heart surgery in the United States of America. Find out more in this report.
Cabinet ministers and other government officials officially welcomed home Prime Minister Moses Nakamoto and wife Sita Nakamoto. A ceremony was held at the official residence of the Prime Minister on Main Street this morning. President David Granger and First Lady Sandra Granger was also a part of the gathering to welcome home the Prime Minister. Leader of the Alliance for Change and Minister of Natural Resources, Raphael Trotman, congratulated the Prime Minister for making it through the surgery successfully. The AFC colleague reflected on his first encounter with Nakamoto in the early days in law studies. Trotman said the Prime Minister may have come into the ranks of the AFC from the People's Progressive Party. However, his detractors cannot take that away from him.
As I have observed you in Parliament in particular, from the opposition benches, as I've observed you as Speaker of the National Assembly, and I have now come to observe you as a member of the government side, I think, and I say without fear of contradiction, that there's no better speaker or orator in the land or nation of Guyana than you, sir. It is always a particular pleasure, like when one witnesses a batsman of class and eminence going to the crease, one has great expectations that you have never failed us. And so we welcome you back. We look forward to your presence in the House. And we say to your wife and family, we know that we have a duty to take care of him, and we will not let you down. Thank you for taking care of him for the last few months. Thank you for bringing him home to us. Thank you for your care of him. We know that we have a duty as well, and we will not fail him, or we will not fail you, sir.
Chairman of the AFC and Minister of Public Security, Kemaraj Ramchandran, also welcomed back Prime Minister Moses Nakamoto. He also reflected on the decades of relationship the two shared in the political sphere.
And that expertise and experience that you bring to us is something that we all will always cherish. You are, of course, a political heavyweight in these parts. And when you have a political heavyweight around you, you feel safe, you feel encouraged. Just like if you were to have Muhammad Ali around you, you'd definitely feel all the better.
Nikhil Jondo reporting for MTV News Update.
More news still ahead. Do stay tuned.
Tell you. Our secret! So they can't tell you! A secret of a secret! Miko, palam!
The heavy catch you!
The secret is out! Tyo's Future Shop is the absolute best place to shop if you're looking for quality products at the lowest prices in the widest possible variety. Choose from a vast array of custom-made quality wooden furniture in endless designs. Electrical and household appliances. Clothing. Cell phones and accessories. And much, much more.
Oh my God, so much in this store, guys. Me confused. And a price low, though.
Tayo's Future Shop and Household Appliances. Located at Anna Katerina, West Coast, Demerara. Free delivery available.
Credit, now me know the secret.
I like all you know the secret. Everybody know the secret.
So what we gonna do now?
Let's go fries and dressing.
Yeah. I'm in love with the shape of you. We push and pull like a magnet.
I'm just having a good time.
And though my heart keeps falling too, I'm in love with your body.
Make that fashion statement today with Classic Styles. It's our 50% off sale on all evening cocktail, prom and club dresses. Classic Styles, 117 Regent Street, telephone 223-1594.
Classic Styles, simply the best!
Here's the Lit News Update, welcome back. The second largest party in the six-member coalition, the Alliance for Change, is not contesting the upcoming local government elections alone. The party has finally decided to unite with the APNU before going to the polls. Finalist Nikhil Jondu tells us more.
Local government election is scheduled to run off in November, according to the Minister of Communities, Ronald Bulkan. The Alliance for Change had previously disclosed that the party is unsure if it will be contesting the elections as one with a partnership for national unity. Following this, the APNU had claimed that it is confident in contesting the LGE alone. As the election month closes in, the AFC has made a pronouncement. Chairman of the Alliance for Change, Kemraj Ramjetan, on Wednesday confirmed that the AFC will unite with the APNU to contest the local government election in November. The AFC chairman said the party has taken the decision at the leadership level. He noted that certain issues will have to be dealt with in terms of candidates and candidacies.
Yeah, well, we had made a decision that we are going as a coalition. We have to thrash out a number of issues, as preferably it will be in relation to candidacies, candidates, a number of other things.
The AFC chairman said the party has dispatched a letter to leader of the APNU, President David Granger. The chairman noted that he appreciates the role President Granger has played in assisting him with security matters. Ramjetan pointed out that AFC ministers do get along well with APNU ministers.
You have that even in a homogenous party, whereby the leaders of that party will get along. Like, if, but you can have a lot of members on the ground being very critical and, you know, fighting it out and abusive and all of that. And that happens even in homogenous parties. But in our coalition government, I have to say that we have had our disagreements, but we dealt with it very professionally and we trashed them out. We come to middle ground and we debate. We debate very heavily in cabinet.
Nikhil John, the reporting for MTV News Update.
The parking meter is one step closer to returning to the city of Georgetown as councillors voted in favor of the amended bylaws. The price for parking per hour when the project recommences will be $150 per hour. Yanis Abrams tells us more.
The amendment to the bylaws of City Hall has been approved following a vote during a special statutory meeting. This paves the way for the return of the parking meter project, which is dreaded by some. 13 councillors voted for the amendment of the parking meter bylaws. The two who objected to the motion were People's Progressive Party councillors Kaim Sharma and Bishram Kupen.
Councillors attempting to move forward with a contract, which even the government had stepped in and suspended that parking meter agreement. You had reviews done by the Ministry of Finance, and many of those issues are not yet addressed by whatever is going on here. The fact of the matter is that we're attempting to pass or approve bylaws for a contract that is yet not being proven to have come about in a legal manner. So there were indications, there were statements made at the same council that this was approved by the previous council, but there is no evidence that we produced so far to prove that. And the fact of the matter is that due diligence was being conducted after the fact, when in fact it should have occurred before that contract.
Now that the bylaws have been passed, Mayor Patricia Chase Green stated that it will be placed at public buildings for 14 days, which will allow persons to review the recommendations. Following that process, the amended bylaws will be forwarded to the Minister of Communities, Ronald Wilkin, for his approval.
The process to be followed is that it will be up to public viewing. The process for public viewing at the National Library, the General Post Offices, the Town Clerk's Office, all buildings of the Mayor and Councillors of the City of Georgetown, all markets, all post offices, and any other place of public viewing for 14 days. The last time I asked the Town Clerk to keep it out for at least 18 days of which it did. But somehow in the presentation that was not said, and so it was ruled that the process of the viewing by the public, and during that period of time, any member of the public can write, submit texts, whatever it is, to the office of the Town Clerk on any matter of the bylaw during that 14 days of viewing.
Parking meters were introduced into the city in January last year. The contract, which was signed between Smart City Solutions and the Mayor and City Council, was seen as secretive by many. After many outcries from citizens, the government suspended the parking meter project for 3 months. Two committees were established subsequently to bring a solution to the parking meter project. The chairman of the last committee, Akin Peter, stated citizens will pay for time and not for space. The cost for parking in the city was reduced by 25% to $150 per hour. Reporting for MTV's News Update, I am Yanis Abrams.
School of the Nations is planning to hike its fees, claiming that its operational cost is very high. Following the announcement, the Minister of State, Joseph Harmon, affirmed that the Minister of Education will be looking into the matter. Here's more from Yanis Abrams.
As concerns are being raised following the action of May schools to increase fees, Director of School of the Nations, Dr. Brian O'Toole, says there are plans to raise the school fees as well. The director stated, as a business person, operational cost is always high, but the school's administration will not hike the fees to an unaffordable sum.
You ask any business person anywhere in the world and operations increase, electricity price increase, everything increases. So Nations is looking at it. We will not increase fees by that extent, but it's the nature. Cambridge University increases their fees every year. That's what people do all over the world. But I don't, we will not increase our fees by 40%, but it's likely that we will review the fees, because if we want the best possible education, we charge at the moment maybe $1,200. In international terms, that's a very, very low figure.
When News Update asked the director how much the school intends to increase the fees, Dr. O'Toole was unable to answer. Meanwhile, Minister of State Joseph Harmon mentioned during the post-cabinet press briefing that the matter is yet to be discussed at cabinet level. Further, the Ministry of Education will have to look into the hike in fees to see if the action was unreasonable to citizens, affirmed Harmon.
You're aware that during last year, when the government introduced some fees on the private schools, that were the fees that they were charging, when they introduced a taxation on it, there's a big hue and a cry by the same citizens who are now complaining that the private schools are charging them as much as, I believe, 42% increase. Now, the Ministry of Education, certainly, I believe, we'll have to have a look at this to see whether it is, in fact, an unreasonable impost on citizens.
During the 2017 national budget, Minister of Finance Winston Jordan had announced a 15% VAT was placed on private education. After many cries by persons, in the following budget presentation, the tax was eliminated, effective from January 1, 2018. Reporting for MTV's News Update, I am Yanis Abrams.
More news still ahead. Stay with us.
What good is history if you never change? And what good is change if it doesn't make you better? At Valvoline, for the last 150 years, we've been doing just that. Relentlessly pursuing innovation for your engine. Backed up not just by science, but by the hands-on expertise that drives everything we do. Valvoline, 150 years under the hood.
Everything is connected, our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Mark?
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens. Lens has a huge selection of various tiles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our three locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
This is MTV News Update. Thank you for staying tuned. Junior Minister of Public Infrastructure Annette Ferguson, who recently visited Pomeroy Suppanam, also touched down in the remote village of Strong Hope and met some amazing women, and that together continue to jointly bring about simple means of empowerment and employment to the women of their community. Let's hear more from LaShonda Gomes, Cornelius.
During a visit to the village of Strong Hope, located in the Pomeroon River, Minister within the Ministry of Public Infrastructure, Annette Ferguson, met with a group of women who have taken inspiring strides to formulate a joint business. This business provides the women with a steady means of income. According to chairperson of the Strong Hope Success Enterprise Women's Group, Yolanda Ashby, the group entails about 12 women that pool their efforts, labor, and creativity into various empowerment and developmental projects within their community. Ashby indicated while herself and the other women work very hard to make an honest living in such a remote community, at times they are faced with various obstacles that hinder their drive to work. One such obstacle is that of damage caused to coconut palms and other cash crops due to floods during the rainy season or due to clogged drains. Whilst meticulously squeezing the coconut milk from the fruit's grated fiber, Ashby related her concerns to Minister Ferguson. The minister, who partook in the initial production of extra virgin coconut oil, stressed how important it is that the group be afforded every opportunity to succeed and expand in their joint endeavors.
So I'm happy to be here in the Pomeroon with these ladies who call themselves Strong Hope Group.
Success Enterprise.
Success Enterprise. They can see the name says it all, because the ladies that are actually doing this, they're strong. I know men don't ever estimate us women. So you see, another strong woman joined them today, Annette Ferguson.
Mm-hmm.
To show how these people in these far-flung areas work hard. You know, the sacrifices they're making. And I'm happy to at least get a feeling of their experience.
Before her departure, Minister Ferguson assured the women that the Ministry of Social Protection's Sustainable Livelihood and Entrepreneurial Development SLED program will assist them with their enterprise while providing other young people employment opportunities. Reporting for MTV News Update, LaShonda Gomes, Cornelius.
Minister of State Joseph Harmon has revealed that a referendum will be held later this year for persons to vote on the performance of the Mayan City Council. Here's more. Minister State Joseph Harmon says the government will allow the City Council to carry out its mandate. However, intervention can occur if City Hall requests intervention or in cases where citizens' safety is affected. The minister stated that later this year, persons will state their satisfaction or dissatisfaction with the performance of City Hall.
And later on this year, or sometime later this year, you will have an opportunity to have a referendum as to whether, in fact, you believe the city fathers and mothers are doing a good job. And so allow them to function, because it must not be said that, oh, we were not allowed to function, this is why this didn't happen or that didn't happen. Give them an opportunity to do what they have to do, and let us move on from there.
Following consecutive weeks of protests from the public, the government suspended the parking meter contract in March last year. Minister Harmon says the government had requested that certain changes be made in the contract, which will allow for proper order in the city. With this, the City Council peruses the procedures under the stipulated bylaws in which the City Council operates.
What we felt is that there's need for order in the city, and that the City Council, in its deliberation and its judgment, recognize that this is the way to go, and I believe that we must allow the City Council to function as a City Council, and not just as an arm of government. The people elected them to govern the affairs of the city, and they must be given that opportunity to govern.
The price for parking per hour when the project recommences will be $150 per hour. This follows a majority vote in favor of the amended bylaws for paid parking by councillors of the City Council. Salahad high-level team to attend the 72nd session of the Marine Environment Protection Committee. Stay tuned.
Introducing the new Softex toilet tissue, now available across Guyana. Softex is silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp. Softex is soft and gentle to every touch. Even babies can use it. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. The choice is clear. Choose Softex toilet tissue. Super soft and super durable. Guaranteed.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
You're tuned to News Update. Welcome back. According to Minister of State Joseph Harmon, Guyana will be sending a delegation to the 72nd session of the Marine Environment Protection Committee during the period April 9 and 13 in London, United Kingdom. Here's more from Lashana Gomes Cornelius.
Minister of State Joseph Harmon explained that the meeting will highlight and address issues affecting the environment, with issues such as ship source pollution, oil spills, greenhouse gas emissions, sewage and garbage within waterways and oceans being under the remit of the Marine Environment Protection Committee. Minister Harmon stressed how impactful the meeting will be for the mitigation of various environmental disasters.
The remit of the Marine Environment Protection Committee is also concerned with ballast water management and pollution preparedness and response. The meeting will address such issues as the technical cooperation for the marine environment, reduction of greenhouse gas emissions from ships.
In addition to that, Minister Harmon indicated that the meeting will serve to address issues such as the international certification of fitness for the carriage of dangerous chemicals on ships.
The meeting will also provide a forum for the sharing of knowledge and information for the environmental impact of oil spills and the mitigation of its adverse effects. Mrs. Claudette Rogers, Director General of Maritime Administration Department, Ministry of Public Infrastructure, and Mrs. Barbara Haley, Director of the Frontiers Department, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, will attend the meeting.
With Guyana's oil and gas sector slowly becoming a subject of deep interest and concern to many Guyanese, the administration on a series of occasions have been posed with repeated questions on whether the state is efficiently prepared to handle unpredictable and dangerous matters such as oil spills once the full production of oil and natural gas begins in 2020. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes Cornelius.
School of the Nations will now be offering a new course, Certificate in Education Leadership. Leaders from other countries are presently in Guyana to witness the launch of this new course, which will be headed by the University of Cambridge. Yanis Abrams filed this report.
School of the Nations is hosting the first Caribbean Conference on Education Leadership. The conference is being organized in collaboration with the Ministry of Education and the British High Commission. Director of School of the Nations, Dr. Brian O'Toole, stated the conference will be held from April 5 to 6. The director further mentioned, leaders from across the world are in Guyana to witness the launch of the Certificate in Education Leadership program.
The plan is, we plan now to talk to LRTT to introduce it in Afghanistan and Gambia, because the need is there in every country for this. Because without leadership, we've got no hope. I mean, that's the only way the world is going to change. And if it can't change within schools, then how are we going to hope that the world is going to change?
Several persons from countries like Afghanistan, Argentina, and the Gambia spoke about their purpose of being a part of the workshop. Administrator of the Limited Resource Teacher Training, Emily Finnegan, stated that 30 well-recognized and qualified teachers are expected to come to Guyana from the United States to conduct training in the Northwest Rupununi.
Right now we work in 10 different countries around the world, and we believe that teacher quality, or quality of our teachers, is really the key to ensuring that every child has a rich education and that experience. So many teachers, and Guyana included, don't have access to quality training, or they're looking for more support in those areas. So what we do is we partner teachers from the United States, from the UK, from Australia, who are also looking to learn and looking to prepare themselves for an ever-globalized classroom, to partner with local education agencies in one of 10 different countries.
The director mentioned this has been a hard task to collaborate with international leaders. He also noted there have been efforts in the past to have a conference like this. Reporting for MTV's News Update, I am Yanis Abrams.
With the 25th Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting nearing, Minister of State Joseph Harmon earlier on Thursday, April 5, announced that a delegation from Guyana will be attending. Details in this, Lashana Gomes Cornelius.
According to Minister of State Joseph Harmon, President David Granger, along with a delegation, will be attending the 25th Commonwealth Heads of Government meeting during the period April 16 to 20 in London, United Kingdom. The meeting, which will be held under the theme Towards a Common Future, will address platform goals such as that of prosperity, security, the promotion of good governance across the Commonwealth, and sustainability, with a view of building resilience in vulnerable states in dealing with the effects of climate change, the minister indicated.
The theme of the summit Towards a Common Future will have four main goals, and they have been proposed for consideration as follows. One, prosperity, boosting intra-Commonwealth trade and investment. Two, security, increasing cooperation in response to security challenges, including global terrorism, organized crime, and cyber attacks. Three, fairness, promoting democracy, fundamental freedoms, and good governance across the Commonwealth.
Minister Harmon further explained that President David Granger will be afforded the opportunity to present on Guyana's role and efforts in the green agenda of the Commonwealth.
It will be pointed out that 2019 will mark the 30th anniversary of the establishment of the Ariokrama Reserve. It would also be recalled that Guyana recently dedicated the approximately 700,000 hectares of the protected area of Kanishan, the home of our Waiwai people in the South Rupununi, in the Queen's Commonwealth canopy. Guyana will therefore use the opportunity of the Heads of Government meeting to continue its leadership role in the establishment of the Green Agenda of the Commonwealth, and we do so as we seek to establish a green economy and green state as our model of development.
Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes Cornelius.
Stay tuned for the Guyana Stock Exchange as well as the Demar Harbor Bridge schedule.
The whispers in the morning of love and sleep. I'm rolling by like thunder now as I look in your eyes. I hold on to your.
The circle starts with solid support and a smile. This is real life with its ups and its downs. This is going the extra mile. And the feeling you get when you can help someone along their journey. Through the twists and turns, we're here. This is Western Union, making sure your support reaches its destination. This is Western Union, moving money for better.
So much Windex for clean windows, all them fancy curtains, it's not even Christmas.
Hi girl, mind your own business, I got big plans.
But BB, your house don't even have windows.
Girl, you ain't think I
know it ain't got window?
Yes, I know it ain't got window. But look, Mokesh promised me that he carrying me down by the window factory when he come home at Eccles. It named Beeson. Like you ain't know nothing, girl. Right now, everybody talking about how Beeson got the strongest windows. Plus, they got a deal right now. If you buy 10 windows, you get a free bathroom window. So I could mind your business instead of you minding me own.
Beeson Windows and Doors, serving Guyana with the highest quality standard windows for your home, office, or commercial building.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
The Guyana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 767. Let's turn our attention to the Demar Harbor Bridge schedule. That's all we have for you in our newscast tonight. But before we go, here's a recap of our major headlines. Military presence of Guyana-Venezuela border heightens following continuous reports of armed gangs in the area. AP and UNAFC to contest local government election as one party. Prime Minister Moses Nagamoto returns home following a heart surgery. And parking meter one step closer to return. The newscast can be viewed online on MTV's Facebook page and also on our YouTube channel. The news will be rebroadcasted later tonight at 23 hours and at 6 hours 30 on Friday, April 6. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar, thanking you for watching. Have a good night.